guys. Very interesting talk. I think I start all my talks with very interesting, hopefully, about menstrual cups, about menstrual health, and specifically how to use cups, how to keep them clean. So I received a lot of questions for you. So today I'm going to answer these questions, but most importantly, I'm going to show you a lot of things, including actual sterilizer. I brought sterilizer here, so we go step by step about opening this cup and unwrapping this package to show you how to keep your cup clean, when to sterilize, when it is required, when it is not so much required, you can deal with your cup just with simple water wash. So let's talk all about these things. Then I want to show you, really using a couple of probes, how to insert it correctly, how to avoid your discomfort during these moments, and we'll talk about what can create this discomfort and how to avoid it. Very important last topic, I want to talk about more like psychological fear. Yesterday many of you shared with me these feelings, and thank you very much. You just shared so much fear of this, and let's talk about where this fear is coming from and what we can do to resolve it. First, so far so good, guys who are here, fantastic, thank you for being here live. All your questions please share just a little bit later, because maybe I'm going to address them very quickly, and if I don't address, then you go ahead and share what else we should cover here. So first, most important, so this is Sirona, my favorite brand, and beautiful new package here, so I can show you brand new cup. But I am a user of Sirona cups for almost 2 years now. You saw first time it brought attention to this among all my followers in a story when we went to Greece vacation. We had to travel long time, changing planes in Abu Dhabi, out of all places, really huge airport, and all this hectic time I was wearing white jeans, and I shared in my stories, hey guys, wearing white jeans and having my period, and people said, you're crazy, how you can sit in the on the plane for 10 hours and changing multiple planes wearing white jeans in your period time. So I shared about that I'm using my cup, and yes, during travel times I may not change it very often, but it holds great, it works well. So that was a very fun story, and many of you guys started actually using it also. Main question, why we do it? Firstly, most important reason, 21st century, hello. Using pads, especially those pads that you throw, you use for 2 hours and throw away, this is plastic wastage. You just don't even know how many tons of these pads we throw away in our life, every, you know, woman of reproductive age. There is billions of us on this planet, and please think about it. It's not only for us, it's for our kids, yes? It's for our kids. So correct, that's a huge reason, I think, at least to consider a reusable approach to menstrual health. Second important reason is comfort, personal comfort. You know, you basically forget that you have your period. Many of you guys also notice it. If you install it correctly, today we're going to talk about how to install it. You just walk around and you don't feel it inside. While if you use this big pad, it goes all around, and you feel that heavy thing there, you have to change it. You know, lots of not extremely pleasant things. There, it's only inside you, you don't feel it, you don't see it. You pull it up, you nicely wash it, and you pull it back in, okay? This is beautiful experience, really. I think it's innovation of 21st century, so I greatly recommend you guys for your personal comfort. Reason number three is your budget. Just think about it. You buy your pad, you throw it away. Buy, throw. I don't have, I'm not going to show you guys my current Sirona cup. I bought it in July of last year, and this is June. So for almost 11 months, I was using only one cup that costs, how much Sirona is costing right now? 200, 300, you know, different, you know, but it's really for 1 year. I think it's significant consideration for many people. Okay? Yeah, Jai Hind. On one-time investment, I mean, some people change it once in a year, but even my current cup is in a great, great shape. It's actually done nothing happened to it. If you feel like, okay, once in a year I can refresh it, go for it, not a problem. Then there is, I think this is main three considerations, and I will go into long list of your questions because I just want to make it completely clear after the session what to do, how to do it. So first question was how to keep this cup clean during the periods and between the periods. Look, ta-da! Nice, it comes in beautiful pink package. This is our beautiful cup. Okay, it also comes with a very discreet, you know, package to keep it between periods. You can keep it in your almira. Nobody knows. Very fun, interesting side effect that most of people from previous generation have no idea what it is. Even if you leave it somewhere like this, nobody will even, you know, think twice. While I know I live right now in a joint family, and I see girls, ladies, my sister and sister-in-law, they go through, you know, a lot of efforts just to hide their parts, fresh ones and used ones, God forbid. So they just go through so much of this detective story games to make sure that it's hidden, that nobody can see it. And in the current situation that many of us live with families, I think this is really, you know, discreet way to keep everything, to use everything, especially that you can change it in the comfort of your bathroom. Okay, now when you open the cup and you see your new beautiful, this is size M. Now let's think about the sizes. Three sizes: small, medium and large. Majority of us guys who are average build, average age, we use M. Doesn't matter if you had kids or not. If you are virgin and you happen to be extremely petite, like really truly petite size, you know, then you consider small. You know, if you feel that you're on a smaller side. If you are big boned and you for some reason feel that maybe you have heavy flow, maybe medium doesn't do and you go for large, but very few guys, very few. Somebody said everybody after giving birth through natural delivery should go for large. No, please trust me, no, it will be too big for you. If it's too big, it's not comfortable. Okay, so start with M. I'm sure, you know, 90% of you guys who listen to me will be M comfortable. If you try M and you do see that it's actually not inserted properly and you see a lot of leakage, fine, invest 200 rupees more, buy L. If it's too tight and you cannot even imagine putting it inside, go for S. Yes, I'm just checking questions here. Yes, completely right, Niveda. I think many of us switched to the cups. I believe current count of humans, women in India goes across 500,000 or even more right now. So we're getting to millions of women who switched to the cups. Okay, now next big question people have, okay, great, we have it, but how to keep it so clean that it's safe to use? So during your period, try to keep it inside your body as much as possible. It means after, in my case, I have every 4 or 5 hours, in some cases even longer. I don't recommend to use it more than 8 hours. Some people change it after a couple of hours if they experience super heavy flow. In this case, go to bathroom, yes, pull it, remove blood. Somebody messaged me bloody finger. Okay, remove your bloody finger, clean with, you have two choices. Please don't clean it with soap, it will spoil your cup. Silicone cup will be spoiled by soap. So you can simply wash it with water. Hot or cold, doesn't matter. Please understand, inside your body, there is no harmful bacteria. If you take it outside and put it on your, you know, everywhere, on your, around your sink, that's where it can catch bacteria. So don't do it, just simply take it out of your body with your own hands. Of course, wash your hands. Of course, wash your hands before. Then, wash cup with water and put it back in. That is the safest way. I did it again, traveling across international locations in really not very nice bathrooms. So I simply don't put it on any surface inside these bathrooms, right? Clear? Guys, put me 111 if this is very clear, that inside your body is the safest way. Sirona wash, absolutely. I am also proud owner of Sirona wash. It comes in a liquid. I don't have it here on this table, but it's very similar to this kind of bottle. Again, very, very discreet. You can keep it in the bathroom. Some people, you know, trying to save money, not to buy it, and they're asking me, is it necessarily? Look, guys, it's not necessarily, but it's super nice. It smells so nice, beautiful. I feel that it becomes extremely clean right away. So you can wash it with water if you travel, if you're in the office, you don't want to bring this thing with you. But at comfort of your own house, allow yourself this little luxury. Buy Sirona wash. Along with your cup, buy the wash. It lasts a lot for, you know, for me again, for a couple of months, I use the same bottle of wash. Because smells are so nice, it's like you feel that experience is upscale, luxury experience. Worst case scenario, if you really want to save money, okay, fine, wash with water. Where to buy the whole kit on Amazon? I will share some links today in my stories for you guys. Where to buy it? Yeah, on Amazon, on Sirona website, I'm sure. I buy on Amazon. So this is how we wash it. Now, so during the period, wash, put inside. Now period is over. Wash it again nicely. Some people sterilize it at that moment. That is optional, up to you. You just wash it really clean and put it to your monthly storage in somewhere in discreet place. Next month is coming, your period is coming again. Here, absolutely important to sterilize. 100% important to sterilize after 1 month of storage. Doesn't matter if you sterilized before. During this month in the storage, like it has to be sterilized. Yeah, I just said after period is optional. Why not? If you have 5 minutes to spare, sterilize it. If not, sometimes I just wash it, put to storage, because most important to sterilize it before you put it back inside when your next period starts. Is there any significance in the color? Color or white? I don't know, I think it depends on the size. Maybe large size is blue or small, I don't know. So this one is pink. I don't think there is any significance in color choices here. Then, so how to sterilize it? Option number one, simplest option, boil it for 5 minutes in normal boiling water without any salt or any additional additions and inside. That is okay. I personally find it a bit like in the kitchen. Even if you wake up 5 o'clock in the morning, life is happening. People making chai, people start asking questions. Ooh, yak yak hey. You know, you have to explain. If you're really open-minded person, you have family who completely aware of your menstrual hygiene, that is completely great. Yes, then you can proudly boil it in front of everyone. In my case, we also have cooks, you know, our cook in Gurgaon, or some cleaning ladies coming. I just think, you know, too many things to explain. What am I boiling here? So, I was very, very happy to use this beautiful sanitizer, also coming from Sirona. Now, Sirona brand, forgive me if I don't remember the price exactly. Maybe it was 1,800, maybe something around this. So it's not a huge investment again. I got mine back 1 year ago, still absolutely beautiful, and now I'm going to show you. We're going to talk a lot about hurt or not hurt, so stay with me. For now, we're just sterilizing before it starts hurting. Okay, so let me just do it like... 1 second. Okay, now you can see, this is Sirona. This is my beautiful sterilizer. We put... Yes, we put just a little bit of water. Look, you have good connection, right? Our connection. Somehow I see poor connection here. Can you see me? Can you hear me? 555. Request from you who can still see us. Video is good because now it comes the most interesting moment. We're going to take our cup. Place it here nicely. And, oh, electricity. Press the button. So, you can go back to our and start maybe talking a little bit more. I will show you exactly when it starts blinking. Usually it happens in exactly 2-3. Nice and clean it is. It literally takes 5 minutes, and you can see how simple is that. One button press. And then after we sterilize it, I will show you how to insert it. Now question is it going to hurt? No, it's not going to hurt. Okay, let's speak about it since we have 2 minutes. Why some people experience hurt? So, as everything in life, everything is in your head. If you're super stressed and you expect to be hurt, just like in first time when you have sex, right? Imagine that moment. And if you're feeling super stressed, super conscious about your body, and you expect something awful, if somebody gave you a bunch of limiting belief that sex is going to hurt, so you like, you know, you your muscles so tight, your body is like in this alarm, defense stage. I'm not going to let it go through. I'm going to defend myself consciously, subconsciously. Your muscles are extremely tight. Then for sure it's going to hurt because you're going to push through extremely tight muscles of your body. Now, if you happen to, maybe you remember your first time experience, if you're in love, and you expect only best things to happen, and you somehow avoided all these aunties who told you that it's going to hurt, you don't even know, you didn't get this note that sex hurts. You're like, oh, it's going to be great. Then you're relaxed. Everything is soft. Everything goes smoothly and you enjoy it a lot. Okay, same with your cup. Please relax before you try it the first time. Maybe while you're still learning how to insert it correctly, you might have to do it 2-3 times. And maybe sometimes it doesn't hurt, it's definitely not painful. It may be like, oh, I have to pull it, I have to open it, what to do, let me do it one time again. Because you're learning something new. If you do it after relaxing, take a deep breath, okay? In and out. Do your meditation for 5 minutes before. Whatever you need to tell yourself, I am the ocean, I am the sea, I am full of calmness, and only good things are happening to me, then everything is going to be so much softer and easier. Yes, guys? Okay? Oh, I missed it. 1 second. Here is what happened. This light goes off because of the... Let me just disconnect it from electricity, and I'm going to hold on 1 second like this. We open, steam is coming in. This is the perfectly sterilized cup. Careful, it's going to be very hot, so you can just leave it here for a couple of minutes. Yes, look, it's extremely clean, medical grade clean. So all you have to do at that point, take it, wait a little bit, so don't insert it when it's so hot, of course, obviously. Just do it like this a little bit and put it back. Okay. Oh, also was interesting question. Obviously, you cannot use the same, but same sterilizer. I personally believe you want to share your sterilizer. in hot bacteria, all not going to get infections from that. It's mostly from, how about now? Yeah, I think when I'm switching back and front camera, for some reason, it is buffering. How about now, guys? It's not so much of network. Network is okay. It's more like switching between camera. Now it's all right, yes. Yes, so I was saying, yes, I will save this video. Now what? Now most interesting part comes. Okay, so I'm going to use this one as a prop. Somebody suggested champagne glass for you guys to show me. Don't you think it's what is unhygienic in this, Savita? Could you please elaborate? So now my vagina. Vagina still feel like a buffering here. Put me 999 if it's buffering still. I will switch the network. 999 means buffering. Okay, buffering. Work to avoid buffering. And what are we going to say? Put me 666. Is it perfect now? Perfect now. Okay, perfect now, because we're going to really important moment. How are we going to insert this little glass? Will play the role of our vagina. Don't worry, it's actually, it's not so small, the real vagina. I hope you know. I hope you explored, guys. Also interesting psychological point, that people who really scared of the cup means they never actually explore their private parts by themselves. I highly encourage you, it belongs to you, it's yours. So usually it's slightly longer, but for purpose of our discussion it will do. So two ways to, firstly you have to fold it. I personally like to fold it like really tightly in this little roll. See this little roll? And then you put it inside and it opens up with a little like vacuum created, okay? And yeah, usually it's only this much will show. In real vagina situation, it will be just a tiny, tiny tip showing here, okay? But the point is, vacuum was created because it opened up absolutely perfectly. Now some people say that they feel sometimes they insert it inside and it's kind of like in this position. What to do? Well, simply move it around a little bit, like until it finds its perfect spot, and do this little pop. You know, let me do it like this. See? Pull. Got it? Vacuum created. It means everything inside. Super hygienic. There is nothing more hygienic than things inside you. Blood is hygienic. Yeah? Your vagina is hygienic. If you wash your hands properly and don't touch the sink before touching yourself, it's super hygienic. Don't worry, guys. You can insert your finger inside and it's still hygienic. Yes. Yes. Your pad, actually, speaking about, imagine this is pad where blood is coming for 3 hours outside of human body. Immediately bacterial growth start happening on top of your pad, between blood and the pad, because it's outside of the body. Inside the body, safe and clean. Outside, any kind of stuff can come to you. That is not hygienic. That is not hygienic. And you keep this non-hygienic sliding mess around you for 5-6 days, and you're okay with that. Inside your body is hygienic. Okay, next best practices during the cycle, I will tell you. Next approach, some people say that it takes too much time to roll, so they use, I think it's called U-shape, smiling shape. So make your smiling shape here, same way, put inside. Vacuum create. So try both. Both ways work. What if this, what about pop causing sudden pain or shock? Amy, I think it's happening again if your muscles are rigid. Try to really relax a little bit. This is just a vacuum pop. Look at this little thing. It cannot hurt you. It's so soft. It's much softer than a lot of other things that naturally goes inside your vagina according to human biology. So this is actually very soft. Yes? So it's not going to hurt you. So if you feel this shock, it most likely being psychological expectation of the pain, then work a little bit. I know Amy, that's why I'm saying that she's capable of fully relaxing her brain. So now, guys, for virgins, I don't know. For virgins, let's talk separately about doctors, what exactly, how they can do it. Okay, show first way again. So again, for virgins, guys, let's take it offline. I will ask a doctor how to insert or how to deal if you are a virgin. Most of us here probably not. This is the first way, when you make a tight roll, I like it, because I can, you know, put it in the right, not too deep, like kind of in the middle, then I open it up for the pop, and that's it. Now, how to pull it? No, this stem, you know what I'm showing here right now, the stem is too much out, so that is not comfortable. In usual situation, this cup, of course, is not your vagina. So normal situation, the stem comes out almost like this, so it's not uncomfortable at all. So cup is inside and you pee from different place. Who is asking how you pee? You think you pee from your vagina? Guys, please do me a favor today, after the session, go to the bathroom, take a mirror and go down and explore from which point do you pee and from which point baby is coming out. They're two different things. Okay, so you don't pee from your vagina, you pee from the top, so you pee from here, it comes all the way down, not even touching anything here. Okay, so now how to take it out? I find it very easy to just pull it a little bit, again, relaxing. If you're squeezing and anticipating a pain, it's very difficult. If you just relax, you pull it very softly, very nicely. If you need, you can put your finger just a little bit more, again, to release this vacuum. Like, you know, sometimes we open a can of cucumbers, so we just need to release this air inside a little bit. And then, what if you can't find the stem while pulling it out? Again, just because I know this lady, I'm going to make fun of you. I'm going to say, keep looking, it's still there. It's not so deep, guys, your vagina is not some, you know, endless abyss in the middle of the ocean. It's not going to go anywhere, trust me. It's not going to go deep, so you'll never find it again, and only your archaeologist will discover it later. No, it's shallow, it's not too big, it's not too small. So what may happen, sorry that I made fun of you, so what may happen, that this tip is a little bit inside, so just put your finger just a little bit inside. You can even put your finger like this, even like this, even like this. It's still okay. Yes, it's still okay. Yes, and then you find it. It's still there. Yeah, it's not irritating. Shaft of your glutes. Okay, it's a little bit higher, so nothing irritates there. Everything is really, really. It's bleeding flow is very high. You still put it here. And all your high bleeding comes inside the cup. What is the question? You feel it's overflowing? Then check it. After 2 hours, open it up. It's completely full, great. Wash it and put it back. If it's a super, super heavy flow. Somebody asked a great question. Yeah, thanks, Amy. Of course, it's not going to get lost. It's not going to go all the way into your uterus, so your baby will find it next time. No, please, I'm sorry, guys. Little bit of Google vagina structure, how vagina looks like. Don't worry, it's safe. It's not going to go anywhere. It's just our fear. This needle is not uncomfortable at all because it's inside you. So again, if it happens that you insert it and you feel not very comfortable, try to open it up. Insert it again. Great question was about PCOD, ladies, with very heavy flow and a lot of cluttering. And we actually spoke to some doctor yesterday about it, and it was a green light permission. PCOD, ladies, you can use the cup also. If you're really, really concerned, consult with your doctor once again. Make sure he is not some orthodox last century kind of guy, but if it's a normal modern doctor, I'm sure they will be completely fine. Now, wonderful question, Kriti, when you remove your cup and if it's completely over flooded and you do it like very fast and very, you know, rush way, you like do it like and then yeah, you can put your blood everywhere. So please be slow, gentle, keep pulling it very, very slowly, gently. I usually do it in my bathroom with locked door. So I pull it, it has some blood inside, I transfer it to clean, okay? Even if couple of bloods coming here, okay, then I will wash the floor. It never happened to me, then it's complete disaster and everything is completely destroyed. So couple of things here and there possible. Yes, absolutely possible. So in this case, we'll just clean it. Yep. Yes, what else? Yeah, video about virgins. We'll have to do it. When we insert, the flow will be there, but your flow is not like a river flowing all the time. It's actually not so much. So during those split seconds between 2-3 minutes when you're cleaning your cup and putting it back, you're not experiencing, you know, dropping flow on the floor. If it's really so heavy, guys, I think in this case, again, ask your doctor. It should not be a waterfall. It should not be a waterfall. And please don't read so many crazy news. We love this news when tampon get lost inside the vagina and operation required to recover. This is just funny fake news. Nothing is going to get lost. Now, people who I know, in my personal biased sample, maybe 5-10% of people who use it and they don't like it. It still creates a lot of pain. It doesn't go inside. You know, let me answer like a psychologist, and that is also okay. It means you're not meant for it, okay? But again, in my highly biased sample, 5-10% of people, while 90% enjoy it greatly and sending me messages saying, thank you, Katrina, it changed my life. I don't have to throw away and hide my pads. I feel great that I'm not this disastrous person with huge carbon footprint destroying our society. It takes some effort, trial and error. It's all in your brain. If you come to this experiment thinking, oh, it's going to hurt, it's awful, I don't like it already, then it might, your body will say, sure, master, let me show you how it can hurt. If you say, everybody is doing it, come on, I can do it too, then you just relax, nice, put a little pink one inside and continue with your day. You can swim in the, main thing for me, again, vacation time, guys. I don't know, yes, some people swim with tampons. I think it's a little bit strange, because water can come from outside of tampon as well. With this thing, I was swimming in the ocean, I was swimming in the swimming pool. Yes, this is completely, you know, ethical for the rest of people around you in the swimming pool. Yes? Yes? So please don't swim with your pads and tampons. And don't deny yourself a wonderful experience. Also, tampons causing cancer, again, I don't know. I'm not a specialist in tampons. I think it's out of scope of this discussion. I know that this is a medical grade silicone. Medical grade silicone. You can keep it inside for a long time. Sometimes I was traveling, I had to keep it for 10 hours because I didn't want to change it inside airplane bathroom. I know it's not ideal, so don't do it like this at home, guys. So change it every 4-5 hours. But even for 10 hours, it was holding okay. So sterilization before your next period starts, once in a month. Yes? Some people, during the period, they take this cup away for the night. And during the night, they say, I don't know, Why? I just keep it outside. Some people have sex during periods, they remove the cup. In this case, if this cup was outside of your body for more than 2-3 minutes, then sterilize it again before you put it back again. Because remember, inside is safe, outside is not safe. Outside is bacteria growth, right? So if the cup is outside by itself for more than a couple of minutes, please sterilize it. I wear it non-stop. So again, take it out, you know, clean it, put it back in, sleep. What's the problem? That's very, very comfortable. Oh, very good questions about shavings and bikini lines. Guys, I have the whole box of new things from Sirona. I will do it next week. I wanted to have a different life to show you. They have amazing new products, safe also. Shaving and all kind of hair removal solutions. So I will show you. Nighttime is also not going to move, yes. After taking out, you need to wash it with water or Sirona wash and then put it back again. If you take it out, wash it and keep it on your sink for 5 hours when you sleep, then please put it back to sterilize. Boil for 5 minutes or use Sirona sterilizer. Psychological questions. I found many people of you, not many, some people messaged me yesterday saying, I'm just feeling scared. So I replied to follow-up question, what are you scared of? They said, I'm scared of pain. Look at this little case here. Shannon, do you know what is it? It's okay, say. No, I told you. No, it's clean now. Shannon saw that how I was changing it one time. It's for mama period, yes?
Period,
yes, okay. Okay, so fear. Fear comes when, again, look, see, Shannon knows, okay, period is coming, mama have it, no problem. If you have fear of your periods, if you have fear of pain, it's all limiting beliefs, right? So work with your mind, so there is nothing to worry about it. You millions of people use it. You will be completely safe. Yes, what else? What kind of fear? That it's not going to get lost inside. If you cannot exactly locate it for some reason, don't panic. Put your finger a little bit deeper and you will definitely get it out. It's absolutely not possible. If you dropped your cup into the toilet, I would suggest maybe not try to recover it. Again, sterilization is not, it will be a really huge sterilization process too, because toilet is as unhygienic as it can get. Shannon, careful, it's hot. Now, what else you have here? Beautiful product, refreshing. It's called Refreshing Intimate Wash. So this is not the cup wash. Cup wash is a separate product. This is just now, summer. We sweat, we have all kind of rashes. I don't recommend you to use soap on your gentle skin there. Usually soap is too harsh. So this is beautiful. It has Tasmanian fruit, rhodiola, root and some roots of other great extract of the plants, and you can use it very, very gently. It smells fantastic. Shannon, baby.
Milkshake.
Okay. Can I have 5 minutes to finish? 5 minutes. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. 5 minutes. What is this? No. Okay. Then no milkshake. Guys, what else we didn't discuss today? So we spoke about cleaning when traveling. Then you come to any washroom and... Shining, baby, please. Малыш, please. Okay, good bit. So during travel, come to any kind of public washroom. Yeah, sounds bad. But okay, cleaning with water, I've done it before. Not a problem. Not perfect, but possible. Just clean with water, put it back in. You can even, you know, step outside of the toilet cabin, go clean it, put it back in. So, two people using same sterilizer inside the family, yes, okay. Sirona wash or any kind of water. Any kind of water is also okay. Sirona wash is a luxury that all of us can afford. It's just much better and of course much cleaner. Sometimes it's great to have actual wash even when you refresh the cup. What else? Questions? What else we didn't cover? In the meanwhile, I wanted to show... when Shannon went, I was just started speaking about fear, so I thought about it. I think it's actually because we have such a taboo about this topic. Taboo means not allowed to talk about it, not allowed to talk even to our own daughter about it. Right, so because taboo means fear, fear means contraction of the muscles, fear means defense, alarm, don't even touch me there, even you, my own master, don't even touch. Most people who experience this fear, maybe they didn't explore much by themselves, by their own hands and fingers, what is it out there, take a mirror, look inside. I hope you guys have great sexual life. I hope you guys have great masturbation time by yourself. That all involves insertion of some objects inside your vagina, right? So there is nothing scary, nothing unusual about it. It's all of us doing this. It's completely wonderful, great, and important for so many things in your life, including health and money. You know that second chakra, right? Connected with your mind. Your second chakra is blocked by taboo, fear, don't even talk about it. Your money flow will be also less. Okay, wonderful product. Also this beautiful anti-rash cream. So again, if you get to the situation, so it never happened to me before, so this cream is not used because it happened not because of cup usage, but because overall it's hot heat here, so Sirona created separate product for the skin outside. Maybe it's some pimples coming here, so this is just separate product. Again, completely not required to buy it, because as I was using this cup for the last 1 year here in the jungle, I never had any rash because of the cup. But if you happen to have some kind of irritation, that's a beautiful anti-rash, rash-free. It's a rash-free cream. Just like we use on our babies, we can use on ourselves. Super beautiful. I think Kamal missed it. Every time you take it out, you don't have to sterilize it. Every time you take it out, you wash it with water and put it right back in. If you started talking on the phone and you discovered that you didn't put it back in and it's been already 15 minutes, where did Shannon put it? I think Shannon took it with her. So if you discover that it's been 50 minutes and your Sirona cup is still on top of the sink, then you should sterilize it. So use your judgment and remember that outside of your body is not safe, but 2-3 minutes is okay. Quickly clean it under running water, put it back in. If you do it more than 2 minutes and leave it somewhere outside, then bacteria can start growing, better to sterilize it. Any exercises to do it before inserting? Look, I think you guys really overthinking it. That is the problem with our beautiful, intelligent, educated ladies. You're overthinking it. Look, any simple kind of woman who doesn't think too much, they enjoy great sex, they enjoy giving babies natural birth. You know, our grandma who lived on the farm, she would not think twice about such issues. We start thinking, should we do breathing exercises or pranayama or maybe yoga, maybe special asana before inserting them? Don't worry about it. Relax, sit and smile to yourself and take it as experiment. Like everything in life is one nice big change experiment. Yes? And with that attitude, everything will go really smoothly and really beautifully. Any more questions, guys? Actually, I promised you very short video, but it gets almost to 1 hour again. Interesting question. Somebody was using cup for more than 1 year and everything was great, but now she feels that cup is dropping down and being more uncomfortable. Maybe you can buy a new cup. I don't know. I'm using mine for 1 year. So far, experience is exactly the same. Feeling is the same. Yes. So I don't know. My honest answer, I don't know why is it happening. Maybe your own muscles somehow, some other issues not related to exactly to cup use. Can cup lose elasticity with time? Kriti, I didn't experience it. I'm just using it for 1 year. So far, exactly the same. Possible that silicone lose elasticity? I think we can ask the brand. Why not buy a different one once in a year? Why not buy a refreshed one in this case if you suspect that elasticity lost? I know for sure that soap is not very good for silicone. It may not happen immediately, but if you keep soaping your silicone cup, it will lose a lot of proper qualities and flexibility. Yeah. Okay, are you doing good? So that is the products I wanted to show you. Sterilizer, I can share some links with you. You don't need to use lubricant for easy insertion, but if you feel to use lubricant, why not? Why not? But if you use too much of lubricant, you might not achieve that vacuum suction inside. If you put so much in and out and everything is just like a well-oiled machine, and it's like cup will be sliding in and out. So maybe then use lubricant just on the surface, just to go past that scary moment for you that it's not going to hurt. I don't use. Again, my personal opinion is not required, especially because it's your period. Especially everything is already lubricated inside naturally. Yeah, it's 2021. It's a year of changes. It's a lot of things. And you try it. Look, you try it. I think it's most important to at least give it a try. Everything is our heads. It's very important to try it only during your period. Please don't try it in different phases when your period didn't come yet. It may be too dry indeed, and it's not going to work. It works only during your periods, and your muscles will be more relaxed. So that's a great point. If somebody decides, I don't have my period yet, but let me buy it and try it, let me save this video, let me put it on IGTV. 1 week from now, let's talk about epilation. It means removal of hair in home conditions when we don't have our spa and salon. We'll discuss different ways of hair removal 1 week from now. I love this topic. I hope all of you will try. Go over your fear. Write down, this is just my fear, like we do in Dream with Kat, and burn it on this piece of paper. Don't burn your Sirona, burn your fear and go for it. And you will see that you are just more free. You forget suddenly that you have your period, you're much more active and free. Okay? Great! Thank you very much! That was a wonderful session with wonderful questions. Thank you, guys.